Hi, welcome to my 30th lecture on linear and non-linear systems. A linear system is the one that satisfies the superposition principle. So superposition principle means it need to satisfy law of additivity and law of homogeneity. So here are one more definition. The principle of superposition requires that the response of a system to a weighted sum of the signal is equal to the correspondent weighted sum of the responses to each of the individual input signals. Let us see these two laws. What is this? Law of additivity, law of homogeneity. Law of additivity. Suppose in case 1, if you have a system, these two are same system, not different systems. X1 of t signal if you give, you will get output Y1 of t. If you give same system, assume different input, so you will get y2 of t. Now these two output if I add, I will get y1 of t plus y2 of t. So case 2, if you see, x1 of t signal, same these two signals now. Here x1 of t, x2 of t signal. These two signal I will add first. Then I will use single system. Then I will get output z1 of t. If this output is equal to this one, z of t, then we will call the system is satisfying law of additivity. Otherwise, if it is won't satisfy, then we'll call it is a non-linear system. From this only you cannot conclude it is a linear system, because we also need to check law of homogeneity. Law of homogeneity. If it is satisfying law of additivity, then we need to check law of homogeneity. In law of homogeneity, x of t, if I give system, I will get y of t output. So this y of t I am multiplying with some constant k, then I will get k y of t. So next, this box I will shift here, this box I will shift here, that's it. First input I will multiply with some constant k, I will get k x of t. This k x of t I will give to system, then I will get some output. This output and this output, if both are same, then it is satisfying law of homogeneity. Otherwise, it is a non-linear system. Now, if so, law of additivity, law of homogeneity, both are satisfying, then we can conclude the system is linear system. So very very important topic this one. Let us see example 1. Y of t equal to x square of t. Here let us see law of additivity first. In law of additivity we have case 1, case 2. In case 1, see, if I give some x1 of t, okay, you observe the system what it is doing, input and output relation. X of t if you give to system, it is making square, right? So you are getting x square of t. So here x1 of t signal if you take, so what the system will do? Here x1 of t square it will do, right? Now here x2 of t, same system I will take, some different input you assume. So I will get x2 of t square. Now if I add these two, some x1 of square plus x2 square of t, we will get this one, right? Now here same input, x1 of t I will take, x2 of t I will take. I will add first this one, x1 of t plus x2 of t. So what this system will do? It will make square, right? I will get x1 of t plus x2 of t whole square. These two are same? No, right? So this system is not satisfying law of additivity. Then we can tell that it is a non-linear system. No need to check law of homogeneity, because we can tell by using only law of additivity only we can conclude it is a non-linear system. So let us see example 2. Y of t equal to x of t square. So first you need to understand what system is doing. So if you give x of t signal to system, so it is making some kind of time scanning operation. So x of t square it is making, right? Okay, it is disturbing the time. Here, now let us see the law of additivity. X1 of t, if you give to system, what it will do? X1 of t square will get it. Now again one more signal x2 of t if I take, so x2 of t square will get it. So if you add these two, x1 of t square plus x2 of t square will get it. Now same x1 of t signal and x2 of t signal, first I will add x1 of t plus x2 of t. Now I am giving to system. System what it will do? It will disturb the times, right? Performing time scaling operation, right? X1 of t square plus x2 of t square. So now these both are same. So it is satisfying law of additivity. But you cannot conclude it is a linear system. Now also we need to check law of homogeneity. Now let us see. Here only we have one signal. X of t I am taking to system. So we will get x of t square. Now I am multiplying with k constant. K x of t square. Now here case 2 x of t. I am multiplying with some constant k. K x of t. Now I am giving to system. I will get k x of. This is performing scaling operation t square. Right. This is also both are same. It is also satisfying law of homogeneity. So law of additivity and law of homogeneity both are satisfying. So this system is linear system. So in our exams, it is very tough to follow the steps. So I will give simple steps to verify it is linear or non-linear. So step one is write two different equations and add it. And step two, replace input and output terms by two input and output summing terms. If these two equations you will get same, it is satisfying law of additivity. So most of the cases we can tell by using law of additivity only. Some cases law of homogeneity also we required. Let us start with example. So we have a y of t equal to cos t x of t, whether it is linear or non-linear. So I said first you write two equations. So y1 of t cos t x1 of t, this is equation number 1. And equation number 2 is y2 of t cos t x2 of t. So now these two equations you add it. So if you add these two, what you will get? Y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to cos t x1 of t plus cos t x2 of t. This is step 1. Step 2. So where are the input and output? This is input, this is output. Where are the input and output is there? You replace input by x of t by x1 of t plus x2 of t. And output y of t you replace by y1 of t plus y2 of t. Okay. So in this equation, I am replacing y of t is y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to cos t. And x of t I am replacing x1 of t plus x2 of t. Now these two equations are same or different? Same, right? Here we took common, here we didn't take common. That's it. So it is satisfying law of additivity. So this is automatically it will satisfy law of homogeneity also. We can tell it is a linear system. Let us see example 4. Y of t equal to 10 plus x of t. I said write two equations. Y1 of t equal to 10 plus x1 of t and y2 of t equal to 10 plus x2 of t. If you add these two equations, y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to 10 plus 10, 20 plus x1 of t plus x2 of t. Right? This is what we got first one. Clear? Next, where the input is there, you replace x of t by x1 of t plus x2 of t. And output you replace yt of t equal to y1 of t plus y2 of t. So here y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to 10 plus x1 of t plus x2 of t. Now these two are same? No, right? It is not satisfying law of additivity. So it is a non-linear system. Let us see example 5, y of t equal to 3t square x of t square. Here, write in two equations, y1 of t equal to 3t square, so x1 of t square, y2 of t equal to 3t square, x2 of t square. If you add these two, y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to this is, if you add what will happen? 3t square, x1 of t square plus 3t square x2 of t square, right? So this is what equation we got it. Now replace input x of t square we have. This one we have. This is I am replacing x1 of t square plus x2 of t square and output format is should be same. Okay. Y of t I am replacing y1 of t plus y2 of t. So now come on, substitute in this equation, y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to 3t square x1 of t square plus x2 of t square. So these two equations are same, right? So it is a linear system. Let us see example 6, y of t equal to 3 cos t plus 5 x of t. Here I said write in two equation y1 of t equal to 3 cos t plus 5 x1 of t and y2 of t equal to 3 cos t plus 5 x2 of t. So see system format is same. I am giving input x1 of t. I will get y1 of t output. Here x2 of t input I am giving. Y2 of t output I am getting. So I am adding these two. Y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to, if you add these two, what will come? 6 cos t plus 5 x1 of t plus 5 x2 of t. Clear? So now, wherever the input is there, you replace by x of t, you replace by x1 of t plus x2 of t and y of t, you replace by y1 of t plus y2 of t. Okay. So now y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to 3 cos t plus 5 x1 of t plus x2 of t. So these two are same? No, right? Different. So it is a non-linear system. Suppose y of t minus 2 equal to 3x of t plus 2 plus 2x of t square we have. So whether it is linear or non-linear, y1 of t minus 2 equal to 3x1 of t plus 2 plus 2x1 of t square. Y2 of t minus 2 equal to 3x2 of t plus 2 plus 2x2 of t square. If you add these two, y1 of t minus 2 plus y2 of t minus 2 equal to 3x1 of t plus 2 plus 3x2 of t plus 2 plus 2x1 of t square plus 2x2 of t square. This is what equation we got it. Now input we have, here two inputs we have different. Format x of t plus 2, I am replacing x1 of t plus 2 plus x2 of t plus 2 and one more we have x of t square, I am replacing x1 of t square plus x2 of t square and output we have y of t minus 2 and replacing y1 of t minus 2, y2 of t minus 2. So format should be same inside. I am writing two times simply. Clear? So if you replace in this equation, what will get? Y1 of t minus 2 plus y2 of t minus 2 equal to 3 here bracket x1 of t plus 2 plus x2 of t plus 2 plus 2 x1 of t square plus x2 of t square. So both are same, right? So it is a linear system. Let us see example 8, y of t equal to minus infinity to t x of tau d tau. So let us write directly y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to minus infinity to t x1 of tau d tau plus minus infinity to t x2 of tau d tau, right? This is what equation will get, right? Now replace input and output by summing points. Y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to minus infinity to t x1 of tau plus x2 of tau, right, d tau. So both are same, right? So it is a linear system. So let us see example 9, y of t equal to cos x of t. So here y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to cos of x1 of t plus cos of x2 of t. So this is one equation you will get. Next, y1 of t plus y2 of t cos of x1 of t plus x2 of t will get, right? So both are same? No, right? Different, right? So it is a non-linear system. Let us see example 10, y of t equal to 10 e power of x of t. Y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to 10 e power of x1 of t plus 10 e power of x2 of t. This is equation number 1. Next, y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to 10 e power of x1 of t plus x2 of t. This is equation number 2. This both are same? No, right? So it is a non-linear system. Let us see example 11, y of t equal to even part of x of t. So y of t equal to even part of x of t means 1 by 2 x of t plus x of minus t. This is what equation, right? So now let us write this one, y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to 1 by 2 x1 of t plus x2 of minus t plus here 1 by 2 x2 of t plus x2 of minus t. This is number 1 equation. And number 2, y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to 1 by 2 x1 of t plus x2 of t plus x1 of minus t plus x2 of minus t. So these two equations are same, right? So it is a linear system. Let us see example 12, y of t equal to real value of x of t. It is very, very important question, completely twisted question this one. So real value of x of t means, suppose if you have a complex signal x of t cos t plus j sin t, if you have. So in this is a real and this is imaginary, right? So how will you select this real part? So x conjugate of t, if you take cos t minus j sin t, right? So if you add these two, x of t plus x conjugate of t equal to these two get cancelled out, 2 cos t, right? But real value is cos t, right? Both sides I will divide by 2. So this is divided by 2, this is divided by 2. So x of t plus x conjugate of t by 2 equal to cos t. So when you perform this operation, you can fetch or you can collect real value in the given signal, right? So y of t equal to real value of x of t means you can write x of t plus x conjugate of t by 2. So this is what the equation. So now let us see whether it is a linear or non-linear. So I am writing y1 of t plus y2 of t equal to x1 of t plus x1 of conjugate of t by 2 plus x2 of t प्लस एक्स टू कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ टी बाय टू, राइट? सो दिस इज इक्वेशन नंबर वन. इक्वेशन नंबर टू, वाई वन ऑफ टी प्लस वाई टू ऑफ टी इक्वल टू एक्स वन ऑफ टी प्लस एक्स टू ऑफ टी प्लस एक्स वन ऑफ टी एक्स टू ऑफ टी होल कॉन्जुगेट बाई टू. ओके, सो दिस बोथ आर सेम. सो हियर एक्स वन ऑफ टी प्लस एक्स टू ऑफ टी होल कॉन्जुगेट, यू कैन राइट एक्स वन ऑफ टी कॉन्जुगेट एक्स टू ऑफ टी कॉन्जुगेट, राइट? सो बोथ आर सेम ओनली. सो इट इज फॉलोइंग लॉ ऑफ एडिटिविटी, बट वेरी केयरफुल, इट इज ए नॉन लीनियर सिस्टम. Why? Let us see with example. See, let us see law of additivity. X1 of t, if you have cos t plus j sin t, so the system what will do? It will collect real part and reject imaginary part. In this real part is this one. This is real, this is imaginary part. So it will collect real part is cos t will collect and reject imaginary part. Same system I am using for different signal. Here cos 3t plus j sin 3t. So this system also will collect real part and this will reject imaginary part. So real part cos 3t is collected, and here cos 3t I am adding. So cos t plus cos 3t we got output this one. Okay, in case 2, same this x1 of t and x2 of t, cos t plus j sin t, cos 3t plus j sin 3t I am adding first. So then cos t plus cos 3t plus j of sin t plus sin 3t, this system what will do? It will collect real part and reject imaginary part. So it's collected real part, we got output, both are same. So it's following law of additivity, but it will not follow law of homogeneity. Why? Because x of t equal to cos t plus j sin t figure system, it will collect real part, right? So cos t, now in this box some k constant, right? So I will give j, I will multiply with j, so what will get? J cos t will get same j here also we need to keep, right? Now what will happen, this function I am first time multiplying with j means j cos t j into j j square, j square means minus 1, right? Minus sin t. Now the system what will do, it will collect real part only, this is real part, right? This is imaginary part now, so minus sin t is output, both are same, no, right? It is not following law of homogeneity, so it is a non-linear system. Very very important, many times asked in exam. So let us see example 13. Y of t equal to imaginary part of x of t, same here y of t equal to x of t minus x conjugate of t by 2 will come. Okay, this is also non-linear system, you do it yourself. Thank you.